I'm Shamala Siddiqui, Faculty of Physiotherapy and Diagnostics. Today this video, I'll talk about cerebral spinal fluid. So, what is cerebral spinal fluid? Cerebral spinal fluid is a clear fluid that surrounds the brain and the spinal cord. So, it cushions the brain and the spinal cord from the injury and also serves as a nutrient delivery and waste removal system for the brain. So the CSF is manufactured continuously in areas of the brain called ventricles and is absorbed by the bloodstream. CSF leaks occurs when the CSF escapes through a small tear and hole in the outermost layer of the connective tissue. It is called as the duromatter that surrounds the brain and spinal cord and holds in the CSF. Or the hole allows the CSF to leak out. The losses of the CSF causes the previously cushioned brain to sag the inside the skulls, which results in a headache and loss of fluid, also causes a lowering of the pressure within the skull. So this condition is called as intracranial hypotension, and CSF leaks can occur in the brain. Cranial CSF leaks and cerebrospinal leaks are a rare event. Researchers and estimates that they occur in about every 10-1 lakh people. But they also believe that this is an underestimate and that the true number of the people affected remains unknown. They are mostly found in people in their 30 and 40 countries. And CSF leaks are commonly misdiagnosed as migraines and other headache disorder or sinusitis. So anyone can get a cerebral spinal fluid leak. However, they tend to occur, for example, women and people with certain connective tissue disorder like Danon's and Marfan syndromes. People who are obese and have high blood pressure. Many cases of the cerebrospinal fluid leak have no unknown causes. This is called as a spontaneous CSF leakout. And the following are other possible common causes are head trauma or spine injury. Secondly, lumbar puncture and the history of the epidurals or spinal catheters. Certain head and spine surgeries and also epidural injections for the pain relief. And skull-based defects such as meningoencephalitis, high blood pressure, and intracranial hydrocephalus, and underlying the unrelated intracranial hypertension. So, what are the symptoms of a cerebral spinal fluid? Symptoms of the cerebral spinal fluid leak can include headache. Headache which feels worse than sitting up or standing and better when laying down. And may come on gradually and slowly. Next is the vision changes. Vision changes are blurred vision, double vision and visual field changes. And also hearing changes, sensitivity to light, sensitivity to sound, balance problems, neck stiffness and pain. And extra additionally including symptoms like clear, watery drainage usually form only one side of the nose and one ear when tilting of the head forward. And also salty or metallic taste in mouth, drainage down back of the throat and loss of smell. So what are the diagnoses for the CSF and will perform a history and physical examination. Often the doctor will examine your nose with an endoscopy and your clinician may also ask you to lean forward the several minutes to see if the drainage comes out your nose. If the drainage can be collected, it is often sent for the laboratory testing to confirm that is the cerebrospinal fluid. And your ears will also be examined and one or more of the following other tests may be ordered to determine the location of the leak as well as changes in structure and features of the brain and spinal cord. For example, computed tomography, टोमोग्राफी एंड मैग्नेटिक रेजोनेंस इमेजिंग MRI, माइलोग्राफी, सिस्टेनोग्राफी एंड ऑल्सो लंबर पंचर एंड ऑल्सो लंबर पंचर एंड द ट्रीटमेंट फॉर द CSF लीक आउट फॉर CSF लीक डिपेंड्स ऑन इट्स कॉजेज एंड द लोकेशन ऑफ द लीक फॉर एग्जाम्पल क्रेनियल एंड स्पाइन बट इन द यूजली कंजर्वेटिव ट्रीटमेंट्स आर जनरली ट्राइड द फर्स्ट फॉर द लीक एज अ लोकेशन कंजर्वेटिव ट्रीटमेंट्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल बेड रेस्ट लमसम 2 weeks एंड हाइड्रेशनल एंड IV कैफीन इन्फ्यूजन्स एंड सलाइन इन्फ्यूजन्स एंड एक्स्ट्रा एडिशनली इंस्ट्रक्शन फॉर द पेशेंट विद क्रेनाइल CSF लीक एंड अवॉइड द कफिंग स्नीजिंग एंड नोज ब्लोइंग एंड लिफ्टिंग एंड टू टेक स्टूल सॉफ्टनेस टू अवॉइड द स्ट्रेनिंग ड्यूरिंग पावर मूवमेंट्स एंड ऑल्सो द सर्जिकल ट्रीटमेंट्स आर क्रेनियल CSF लीक रिपेयर ऑफ द क्रेनियल CSF डिपेंड ऑन द साइज एंड द लोकेशन ऑफ द लीक एंड लीकेज फ्रॉम योर नोज कैन यूजअली बी रिपेयर यूजिंग नेजल इन टू द ईयर्स विल यूजअली नीड द यूज ऑफ अ माइक्रोस्कोपी After conservative treatments have been tried, an epidural blood patch is the most common treatment for spinal CSF leak. In this procedure, your own blood is injected into the spinal cord, spinal canal, and the blood clot that forms creates a seal to stop the leak. If the several attempts of the epidural blood patches do not work, other grafting materials like epidural fibrin, glue, and fat or muscle patches may be tried. So if these methods are not successful, other surgical approaches to repair the leak out, including using stitches and aneurysm clips. Thank you. Namaste, I am Shamala Satyaki. Today's video I will talk about glomerular filtration rate. A glomerular filtration rate is a blood test that checks how well your kidneys are working. These filters help remove the waste and excess fluid from the blood. A GFR test estimates how much blood passes through these filters each minute. A GFR can be measured directly, but it is a complicated test and requiring a specialized provider. So, GFR is most often stage kidney disease does cause symptoms. So you may will take a blood sample from a vein in your arm and using a small needle. So after the needle is inserted, a small amount of the blood will be collected into a test tube and vial, and you may feel a little sitting when the needle goes in or out, and this usually takes less than 5 minutes. And you may need to fast and avoid a certain foods for several hours for that test. And your healthcare provider and your doctor will let you know if there are any special instructions to follow. And there is very little risk to having a blood test. And you may have a slightly pain and bruising on the spot and where the needle was put in. But mostly symptoms for the kidney, your GFR results may showing. For example, normally you previously don't have kidney disease. Below the normal, you may have kidney disease. Far below normal, you may have kidney failure. If you have questions about your results, and so talk to your health provider and learning more than about your laboratory test and different stages and understanding results, and you can take the steps to prevent further damage. So the blood pressure medicines and medicines to control the blood sugar, and if you have diabetes and lifestyle changes such as getting more exercise and maintaining the healthy weight and living healthful, avoiding the smoking, avoiding smoking, and if you treat kidney disease early, maybe order to prevent kidney failure, and the only treatment option for the kidney failure and our dialysis for the kidney transplantation.
Namaste, IJVM Shamala Siddiqui, Faculty of Physiotherapy and Diagnostics. Today this video I'll talk about estimations of the total protein. So what is estimations of the total protein? Total proteins are, it is the two types of the total proteins. Firstly, albumin and globulin. Albumin and globulins are the two types of the protein in your body. And the total proteins test measures the total amounts of the albumin and globulins in your body, and it is used a part of the routine health checkup. So it may also be used if you have unexpected weight for loss, for example fatigue and any symptoms of the kidney and liver disease. And proteins are important building blocks of the cells and tissues. So the proteins are necessary for your body's growth, for example development and health. Blood contains albumin and globulin. Albumin proteins keep fluid from the leaking out of your blood vessels, and globulin proteins play an important role in your the immune system. So what are the purpose of the total protein test? A total protein test, it is a completed as a part of your routine health checkup, and it is one of the tests to make up your comprehensively medical panel. And it may be a unexplained weight loss and fatigue and edema. So what is edema? Edema, it is an accumulation fluid for the tissues, for example symptoms including kidney and liver diseases. The total protein test measuring the total amount of the protein in your blood and specifically looks for the amount of the albumin and globulin. So the test uses a blood sample that's analyzed in the laboratory. For a blood sampling, healthcare provider and your clinicians will join the vein in your arm for the back of your hand. So firstly, I'll clean the site with an antiseptic wipe. So they will wrap a band around your arm to apply the pressure, and to area gently insert that needle tube the vein. So next, the blood will collecting into the tube attached to the needle, and the tube is full with the band of the needle will be renewing your arm. So in infants or small children, a lancet it is used to puncture the skin and the blood collecting in a small glass pipette. And and many medications can affecting the total protein test results. Medications that can affect the test results including firstly steroids, second androgens, corticosteroids, dextran, and also growth hormone, insulin, and progesterone hormone. What are the risks for the total proteins? Or you may feel moderate pain and discomfort from the discomfort from the body. The total protein ranges are between 6 to 8.6 grams per deciliter, and this range may vary slightly among the laboratories, and these ranges are also due to other factors like age, gender, populations, and testing methods. And the total protein measurements may increase during pregnancy. If the total protein is abnormal, additionally testing must be performed to identify which specific protein is low or high before a diagnosis can be made. Elevated total protein may indicate inflammations and infections such as viral hepatitis B and hepatitis C and HIV infections and bone marrow disorders such as multiple myeloma and Waldenstrom's disease, and low total protein may indicate bleeding and liver disorder. Kidney disorder such as nephrotic disorder or glomerulonephritis and malnutrition, and also malabsorption conditions like celiac disease and inflammatory bowel disease. So the extensive burns, which is an inherited condition and in which the blood does not a type of a globulin but the affecting strength of your immune system. Secondly, inflammatory conditions and low albumin is considered albumin below 3.5 gram per deciliter, but it is associated with decreased effectiveness of the medications and used for the ulcerative colitis. And low albumin level may result in complications during or after surgery. So the next is AG ratio. What is AG ratio? Normally the AG ratio is referred to as the albumin and globulin ratio. It's slightly higher than 1 if the ratio is too low and too high. So the additionally testing must be done to determine the causes and diagnosis. If the ratio is low, so it can suggesting your clinician autoimmune disorder and multiple myeloma, cirrhosis, and also kidney disease. A high AG ratio can indicate genetic deficiencies or leukemia. Make sure to discuss your results and your clinician.